Hello guys, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. I welcome you all in this series of morning tales, that is for your phase 1 of RBI, SEBI, NABARD and other banking examinations at the level of PU. So guys, the questions that I'm going to take up in this video can be of relevance for your upcoming examinations. So do listen to me very carefully till the end of this video. And now, it's the time of an important announcement, and that announcement is that if you are a newcomer here, then you should subscribe to our channel and hit this bell notification. The reason here is that we upload very new kinds of videos on a daily basis. So if you want to get your hands on those videos, then you should subscribe and hit this bell notification. Also guys, you can join this Telegram group where we provide free quizzes as well as resolve your queries. And this is the new launch that we have made for RBI Grade B course. So this is the 2022 course. Actually not new, because we have launched this course back in the month of March. But now I'm introducing this course to you, especially for the people who are watching me for the first time. So let me give a brief introduction of this course and then we will move ahead with the video. Okay, so this new course has PDFs, videos and mock tests. 10 mock tests each for each and every subject. For phase 1, you will have 10. For phase 2, you will have 10 for each finance and management, ESI and English. Apart from this, in addition to all these things, you will have assistance for your interviews as well. In addition to this, you will have a book kit that includes phase 1 question bank, phase 2 question bank, phase 2 revision booklet, phase 1 and 2 past years, starting from the year 2010 onwards, a notebook and a pen. So if you're convinced to buy this course, then you can avail a 30% discount that is being run on this course right now by using RBI30 coupon code. So this is an opportunity for the aspirants of RBI Grade B who are seeking to get themselves enrolled in some of the very useful course, I would say. So if you're looking for a useful course for your upcoming RBI Grade B exam, then you can get yourself enrolled in this course. And if you have any queries, then do call us on this number and get your queries resolved. Okay, so that was all about the introduction. Now we are moving on to the first question. Which state has launched Mukhya Mantri COVID Upchar Yojana? Uttar Pradesh, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh and Punjab are in the options. Out of these, the right answer is option D, Madhya Pradesh. Now, from the name itself, Mukhya Mantri COVID Upchar Yojana, that is this scheme, is catering to the treatment of COVID-19. So this scheme is particularly for the treatment of COVID-19. This is very obvious from the name itself. Now let's look into this scheme a little bit in depth to understand what the scheme is all about. Now the scheme is divided into three parts. So the first part is catering to the government hospitals. So in the first part of this scheme, the government hospitals and community health centers that are being run by the state government will provide free treatment to the COVID-19 patients. So that is the first section of this scheme. In the second section, 20% of the ICU beds will be reserved for COVID treatment and treatment will be provided for free in the private hospitals. So first part was catering to the government hospitals, second is catering to the private hospitals, and third part is for the overall healthcare service sector, in which 20% of the beds will be available for these beneficiaries of Ayushman Bharat scheme. So these are the three parts in which this Mukhya Mantri COVID Upchar Yojana has been divided. Now you have to just remember all the information that I have provided to you here. Apart from this, all the other information related to the scheme is not at all important for you guys. Just remember, this Mukhya Mantri COVID Upchar Yojana is launched by the state of Madhya Pradesh and it has these three sections. And remember the percentage of the beds, like 20% will be provided in the private hospitals and 20% will be for the Ayushman Bharat beneficiaries. Now that's all about this question. Now we are moving on to the next question. What is the name of the app launched by Interpol to help identify stolen cultural property, reduce illicit trafficking and increase the chances of recovering stolen works and artifacts? You have five options: Trace, ID Art, Path, Stock Art, Track Art. So out of these five options, the right answer is option B, that is ID Art. So this ID Art application has been launched in order to track the stolen cultural assets. Just remember this thing: stolen cultural assets, reduce illicit trafficking and increase the chances of recovering stolen works and artifacts. So this is the purpose of this application. Now let's have a look at some of the facts related to Interpol. So Interpol was established in the year 1956 and it has its headquarters in Lyon, France. Remember, headquarters are in Lyon, France. Apart from this, who is the Secretary General of this organization? It is Jürgen Stock and he belongs to Germany. So these are some of the facts related to Interpol that are very important for your upcoming examination. Moving ahead, who heads the RBI's 6-member advisory group set up under the Regulations Review Authority? So this question is very important for you guys. Listen to me very carefully. We have 5 options: S. Janaki Raman, T. Ravi Shankar, M. Rajeshwar Rao, M. D. Patra, M. K. Jain. Out of these 5 options, the right answer is option A, that is S. Janaki Raman. Remember that he is at present the MD of SBI. Before bouncing upon anything related to this Regulations Review Authority, I would like to clarify this thing to you guys that this appointment, T. Ravi Shankar, was appointed very recently as the Deputy Governor of RBI. So this is again a very minor fact but related to RBI, therefore it is important. And all the people except S. Janaki Raman in the options are at present acting as the Deputy Governors of RBI. So that was the additional fact that I wanted to tell you. Now moving back to this Regulations Review Authority 2.0. So first of all, you should remember this thing that the present chairperson of this Regulations Review Authority is M. Rajeshwar Rao. So he is at present chairing this RRA 2.0. Now what is the purpose of this RRA 2.0? Why was it constituted? The purpose is to review the regulations internally, review the internal regulations of RBI, the procedure of making regulations. And in order to simplify that procedure of making regulations through circulars, notifications, so basically it is in order to smoothen the process and not to create the regulation. Remember this thing, Regulations Review Authority, that is to review the regulation making process. So that is the purpose of this member of this RRA 2.0 that has been created by RBI in the month of April 2021. Now, this is 2.0. So when was 1.0 created? The RRA 1.0 was created back in the year 1999. So this was again an important fact that you can remember for your upcoming examination. So on this note, let's move on to the next question. But before that, I would like to ask a question from you guys. And that question is the tagline of State Bank of India. That you have to tell me in the comment section below. Next question is, which company has launched Savdhan Rahein, Safe Rahein public awareness campaign to educate customers and public at large on financial fraud risk? You have 5 options. Out of these 5 options, the right answer is option E, Bajaj Finserv. So this is the financial company that has launched this Savdhan Rahe Safe Rahe public awareness campaign, and the purpose is to create awareness against the financial frauds that are being rampant in today's times. So that is the purpose of this campaign, and apart from this, there is nothing that you can memorize from this news. But again, I have a question for you, and that question is the chairperson of Bajaj Finserv, that you have to mention in the comment section below. Next, who has been appointed as the 38th president of FICCI Ladies Organization? This is an important organization, as well as this appointment is also important. Now you have options, Sarojini Shekhar, Anita Baghel, Ujwala Singhania, Rajni Sharma, Radhika Shah. Out of these 5 options, the right answer is option C, Ujwala Singhania. Guys, remember, she is the 38th president of FICCI Ladies Organization. The number is also important for you to remember. Next question is, who has been awarded the Loris World Sportsman of the Year 2021 award? So these are the 5 options right in front of you: Lewis Hamilton, Patrick Mahomes, Max Parrott, Rafael Nadal, and Billie Jean King. Out of these 5 options, the right answer is option D, that is Rafael Nadal has won this Loris World Sportsman of the Year award 2021. Now, where was these awards hosted? Basically, which city hosted these awards? This is again an important fact that can be asked in your exams. So this award was hosted in a Spanish city of Seville. So the spelling of Seville is, so this is the city where these awards were hosted. And this is the list of winners that have won award at the award ceremony. So Lawrence World Sportsman of the Year award has gone to Rafael Nadal, who belongs to the sport of tennis. Sportsman of the Year award goes to Naomi Osaka, again from tennis. World Team of the Year goes to Bayern Munich from football. World Breakthrough of the Year goes to Patrick Mahomes, who belongs to the sport of football. World Comeback of the Year award, Max Parrott, snowboarder. Sport for Good award, Kick for More by Kick Fair. Lifetime Achievement award, Billie Jean King, she is again from tennis. So remember that Lawrence Lifetime Achievement award has gone to this personality, because Lifetime Achievement awards are important and they can be asked in your examination. Next, Athlete Advocate of the Year award, Lewis Hamilton. He belongs to motor racing. And remember this thing, that this is the first edition of this award. So Lewis Hamilton becomes the important person because he has become the first person to receive this award. Lawrence Sporting Inspiration Award, Mohamed Salah. He is again from football. Sporting Moment of the Year award, Chris Nicking, triathlete. So these were the awardees for 2021 awards. Now it's time for us to say goodbye to each other. I hope that you have learned something in this video, and if you have, then do not forget to subscribe to our channel and like this video. Thank you so much.